I felt we had to talk with Ralph Twice's widow to see how much she knew.
Please go away. Please go away. I don't want to answer any more of your questions.
We're sorry to bother you at a time like this, Mrs. Twice. We would have come earlier, but your husband wasn't dead then.
Oh, Ralph was such a good man. Who could have done such a horrible thing?
Did he owe any money? Doctor bills? Gambling debts? Book of the Month Club?
No, nothing. Just two more payments on our solar telescope. Oh, poor Ralph. Do you know what it's like to be married to a wonderful man for 14 years?
No, I can't say that I do. I did live with a guy once, though, but that was just for a couple of years. Oh. Usual slurs, rumors, innuendos people didn't understand. Oh. Ran him out of town like a common pygmy.
Did he have any enemies?
Well, the Democrats didn't like him.
Sure, he was a physical education major, but he had a mind. He could think. It wasn't all muscle, all body, all sinewy limbs. He got married, you know, later, had three kids. Never cared for her. Sent a nice gift, never got a note.
I know this is a long shot, but did he ever eat chop suey?
Why, no. No, he never did.
It was just a hunch.
I told him she was wrong. And that youngest boy. Just like his father, football hero. Lived with him for a year. Wasn't the same. Can't go back.
Oh, poor Ralph. And what about my daughter? What am I going to tell her?
Yeah, you're going to have to tell her something. Tell her he went on a long trip.
Oh, wait a minute. How about a big monster came and took him to Daddy Heaven?
Oh.
Nah.
What about this? He threw himself on a grenade and saved the battalion. Yeah, that's it.
No, wait a minute. He was killed by left-wing insurgents from Paraguay.
I got it.
No, Bolivia.
I got it. He was traded to the Cubs for Reggie Jackson.
No further progress was made in the next 10 hours. The following morning, I reported back to police squad.